Energy is produced in the core of the Sun through nuclear reactions. Small nuclei combine to form larger nuclei in nuclear fusion and release energy in the process. That energy then makes its way toward the surface of the Sun. There are three major modes of thermal transport: conduction, convection, and radiation. This is our second video looking at thermal transport in the Sun, and we'll specifically study convection, which is the dominant mechanism in the outer part of the Sun. Convection is the actual movement of material in fluids due to buoyancy. Hotter material has relatively lower density, and thus it rises, much like a hot air balloon. Cooler material has higher density, and thus it sinks. We could easily illustrate convection with the following equipment: hot plate, small pan, silicone oil, and aluminum powder. We simply place our silicone oil and aluminum powder mixture into the frying pan and heat. It is possible to ignite the oil, so one wants to know the safe temperature range for the specific type of oil that they are using. Very high temperatures are not needed in this demonstration, and I have set the thermostat for 350 degrees Fahrenheit. As the oil heats up, convection cells are created. Hot material, initially in contact with the bottom of the pan, moves upward and boils over. Cooler material then circulates downward. The aluminum powder serves as a tool that allows us to see the circulation. Here you can see two screens with a visible image on the left and an infrared image on the right of the convection cells in the silicone oil. Realize that in the infrared image, temperature is indicated by color. The white and bright yellow regions are hotter, while the dark and lavender regions are cooler. So material we saw moving upward in the visible video is shown to be hotter in the infrared image, while material circulating downward is cooler. Convection like this on the surface of the Sun is known as granulation. The material that is moving upward at several kilometers per second toward the surface appears brighter, and the cooler material moving downward is darker, giving the Sun this mottled appearance. Convection cells on the Sun are about 1,000 kilometers in diameter. Let's look at a fun example of convection commonly used today in physics classes, known as a teabag rocket. We basically steel the paper cylinder that encloses the tea and use it to display convection. We are going to light the top of the paper cylinder on fire. Let's see if we can predict what will happen. Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in a classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question. We light the top of the paper cylinder on fire and wait for convection to lift it up into the air. The flames heat the air trapped inside the cylinder and above it, lowering its density. Cooler, higher density air from outside the cylinder rushes in to fill the void under the flames, and a convection current is started. As soon as enough of the teabag has burnt away to lower its weight, our rocket is born. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.